I just want to be where you are, dwelling daily in your presence. I don't want to worship from afar. Draw me near to where you are. I just want to be where you are, in your dwelling place forever. Take me to the place where you are. I just want to be with you. I want to be where you are, dwelling in your presence, feasting at your table, and surrounded by your glory. In your presence, that's where I always want to be. I just want to be I just want to be where you are, dwelling daily in your presence. I don't want to worship from afar. Draw me near to where you are. Oh my God, you are my strength. I just want to be where you are, in your dwelling place forever. Take me to the place where you are. I just want to be I just want to be with you.
God said he will cause righteousness and praise to spring forth through all the earth. Today, everywhere you turn, there is a new song, a new spirit of worship, a new sound of rejoicing. Something significant is happening. God himself is doing a new thing among us. The Holy Spirit is resurrecting living worship among his people, paving the way for the King to visit us in ways we've not known before. And just as we've sung, we want to be where you are. He wants to be where we are. In our towns, our churches, our homes, and in our hearts. I really believe God arranged for us to gather tonight because he wants to demonstrate his grace and glory. As deserving as he is of our worship, and as much as he delights in our praises, he didn't design this practice for his benefit. Worship is for our sake, because worship is the atmosphere which welcomes his presence and gives place to his mighty works. So friends, this meeting is his idea. He brought us together to move among us. God with us. Thank you. Aren't you thankful God is with us? He's here. He's with us right now. Yet some of you may be going through circumstances that make it difficult to believe that He is. Throughout God's Word, the invitation is clear. Come unto me, all ye who are weary and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. But many of us feel unworthy, unready to respond to His invitation because of guilt. We focus on our weaknesses rather than on His mercy. But the blood of Jesus has made it possible for you, for me, to come boldly to the throne of grace, to receive mercy and grace to help in time of trouble. So let's respond to His invitation right now and enter in.
Sheep have gone astray, each of us turning our own separate way. We have all sinned and fallen short of your glory, but your glory is what we desire to see, and in your presence is where to your holy place. Forgive our sin and heal our land. We long to live in your presence once again. Taking our sickness, Jesus, the sacrifice lamb has been slain. He was despised, rejected by men. He took our sin. Draw us near to your Father through Jesus, your Son. Let us worship before you, cleansed by your blood. To your holy place, forgive our sin and heal our land. We long to live in your presence once again. Show us your mercy and grace. Take us to your holy place. Forgive our sin.
Like weary sheep, we seek a fountain. Like lost children, we seek a home. There is a longing for the presence of the one who made us for himself. So call with me now. Lord, it's you we need. It's you we want. And we long to be in your presence once again. You see, God inhabits our praises, so he's here to meet every need you have according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. So rest in him and let him work on your behalf.
Strong and take courage. Do
and take courage. Do not fear or be dismayed, for the Lord His light will show the way.
Be strong and take courage.
Do not fear or be dismayed, for the one who lives within you will be strong.
Let's pray. Lord, we thank you that your strength is made perfect in our weakness. When we are weak, you are strong, and you are able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we could ever ask or think. You are El Shaddai, our fully dependable provider, so great and so faithful.
Kings, Lord of lords, I worship you.
Cast all your care on Him, because He cares for you. This is more than a promise. It's a command. Be at rest, child of God. You've placed your burden at His feet, your request in His hands, and your faith in His word. So let's rest in His promise and worship Him in spirit and truth, offering Him sincere praise as we bless His holy name.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. He is worthy to be praised and adored. So we lift up holy hands in one accord, singing, blessed be the name, blessed be the name of the Lord.
Let's sing it together.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. He is worthy to be praised and adored. So we lift up holy hands in one accord, singing, blessed be the name. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
our joy as we worship right now, gathered under His grace and surrounded by high praise, is not an escape from reality. With all the power inherent in His presence, it's still a fact that all of us face tough times. Times a lot different than these moments of celebration. But tough times don't diminish the reality of His presence. Darkness will fall and clouds do gather. Shadows will come, but our faith and our confidence in Him need never be shaken. And when we face difficult times and trials, He will be with us to make a way. Remember receiving the phone call from my mother-in-law late one night, informing me that my wife's sister and husband had been involved in a terrible car accident. They had four young boys. Jeremy, the oldest, who was soon to be 9 years old, was killed instantly, and the other three were seriously injured. I felt so helpless when I heard the news. All the scriptures that came to my mind seemed to fall short of what I really wanted to say to them. But as I was praying for them, God gave me a song, and I wrote down the words, "God will make a way where there seems to be no way. He works in ways we cannot see." That's what I really wanted to say to Susan and Craig. God is working in ways you can't see. I wanted to give them hope in a hopeless situation. You may be going through a similar situation today, and you feel that God has forgotten you, but He hasn't. The Bible tells us that He has inscribed us in the palm of His hand. He is a God who can make a way where there seems to be no way.
To the end of my rope. Like a watch that had been wound too tightly, I broke. All I could do was cry uncontrollably. I felt like a huge black cloud was hovering over me, and I couldn't escape. I didn't want to live, so I prayed that I would die. I knew that God was my answer, but I thought it was too late. I had been a Christian for many years, but I'd become too busy to talk to God. And I didn't often give Him the chance to talk to me. It wasn't until I fell flat on my face that God got my attention. My husband checked me into the hospital where I was diagnosed with severe depression. I was in the hospital for 9 days, and there I discovered that in God's love, I have unconditional acceptance. I need never fear rejection because He says He has put His seal upon me and given me His Spirit in my heart. Finally, I came to the place where I realized that even in my despair, God had been with me all along.
God has promised He will never leave us nor forsake us. In Christ, God has revealed His faithfulness to us from the beginning of time.
In Genesis, Jesus is the ram at Abraham's altar. In Exodus, He's the Passover lamb. In Leviticus, He's the high priest. In Numbers, He's the cloud by day and pillar of fire by night. In Deuteronomy, He's the city of our refuge. In Joshua, He's the scarlet thread out Rahab's window. In Judges, He is our judge. In Ruth, He is our kinsman redeemer. In 1 and 2 Samuel, He's our trusted prophet. And in Kings and Chronicles, He's our reigning king. In Ezra, He is our faithful scribe. In Nehemiah, He's the rebuilder of everything that is broken. And in Esther, He is the Mordecai sitting faithful at the gate. In Job, He's our Redeemer that ever liveth. In Psalms, He is my shepherd and I shall not want. In Proverbs and Ecclesiastes, He's our wisdom. And in the Song of Solomon, He's the beautiful bridegroom. In Isaiah, He's the suffering servant. In Jeremiah and Lamentations, it is Jesus that is the weeping prophet. In Ezekiel, He's the wonderful four-faced man. And in Daniel, He is the fourth man in the midst of a fiery furnace. In Hosea, He is my love that is forever faithful. In Joel, He baptizes us with the Holy Spirit. In Amos, He's our burden bearer. In Obadiah, our Savior. And in Jonah, He is the great foreign missionary that takes the word of God into all of the world. You go on and you see in Micah, He is the messenger with beautiful feet. In Nahum, He is the avenger. In Habakkuk, He is the watchman that is ever praying for revival. In Zephaniah, He is the Lord, mighty to save. in Haggai. He is the restorer of our lost heritage. In Zechariah, he is our fountain. And in Malachi, he is the Son of Righteousness with healing in his wings. In Matthew, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. In Mark, he is the miracle worker. In Luke, he's the Son of Man. And in John, he is the door by which every one of us must enter. In Acts, he is the shining light that appears to Saul on the road to Damascus. In Romans, he is our justifier. In 1 Corinthians, our resurrection. In 2 Corinthians, our sin bearer. In Galatians, he redeems us from the law. In Ephesians, he is our unsearchable riches. In Philippians, he supplies our every need. And in Colossians, he's the fullness of the Godhead bodily. In 1 and 2 Thessalonians, he is our soon coming King. In 1 and 2 Timothy, he is the mediator between God and man. In Titus, he is our blessed hope. In Philemon, he is a friend that sticks closer than a brother. And in Hebrews, he's the blood of the everlasting covenant. In James, it is the Lord that heals the sick. In 1 and 2 Peter, he is the chief shepherd. In 1, 2, and 3 John, it is Jesus who has the tenderness of love. In Jude, he is the Lord coming with 10,000 saints. And in Revelation, lift up your eyes, church, for your redemption draweth nigh. He is King of kings and Lord of lords.
Yeah.
Thank you for being with us, Lord. We bless your name. Tonight, we have entered his gates with thanksgiving. We have entered his courts with praise. And we have seen through his word that God has always made a way for us. He is the God of the past, the God of the present, and he is the God of the future. He is Emmanuel, God with us. So let's lift our voices and give him thanks for being with us here tonight.